So my name is Chris Stamp, aerospace engineering student here, winning the undergraduate researcher award. That's mostly for all of the work that I've done with the University of Buffalo Nanosatellite Laboratory. I tried to figure out what to get involved with. I ended up finding the Nanosat Lab and Dr. Gracides. He's really taken me under his wing and helped me kind of figure out what I wanted to do. So, you know, here I am 5 years later graduating aerospace engineering and mathematics, so couldn't be happier with that. I'll be staying here for a PhD, studying under Dr. Gracides, continuing some of the same work, but also starting down some kind of new things that I've found passions for and that I'm excited about. You know, I do have my own kind of fun side projects, but, you know, I also think that there's a lot of benefit from a balance to that, right? You know, I like rock climbing. It's just kind of to clear my mind and kind of separate myself from all that. I've just absolutely loved my time at UB. I think that all of the faculty has been really great, not just in terms of, you know, classes, because I do think, you know, most of the time, wherever you end up going to school, you know, your coursework, your classes, they're going to be very similar in terms of what you're reading and what you're, you know, trying to learn and understand. But the faculty here is really great at, you know, tying in those concepts into real world things, and really great about helping you get involved with research or other kinds of projects that can help kind of bridge that gap from the theory into reality, which I think is a really important thing for all engineers and scientists. So I think that has been one of my favorite kind of experiences here, is just all of the opportunities to really get involved and apply that knowledge to things.
So my name is Leah Holland. I'm a junior in aerospace mechanical engineering, and I won the humanitarian award. Outside of classes, I'm involved in the NanoSat program. I'm program manager there. I've been involved with Society of Women Engineers, Women in Science and Engineering, the Students for Exploration and Development of Space, and I've also helped out with the Dean's Office when I do the Science Elementary program. I was referred to a summer camp that actually took place at UB my junior year of high school, so I figured, why not? Came on, and I had time of my life here, and we worked in a team and built styrofoam drones. And after that, I figured, you know, I think this is what I want to do. So then I came on to UB with just mechanical, because I wasn't sure what I wanted to do with it yet. I joined Nanosat Lab and realized that aerospace really is my place, and so I then changed the double major. So when I first came into school, I thought of engineering as just people who are like inventors and people who just build things. And all right, so that was something we could start with. But now looking forward, I see engineers not necessarily as inventors, but more like problem solvers. What it's about is training your mind to think in a different way that you can solve these really tough problems that no one else wants to solve. I grew up in a family that was very dedicated to community service. My mom was always involved in like the PTO and things like that, and she helped like run my Girl Scout troop, so she was very involved. And my father was also a volunteer fireman. The legacy began with my grandfather in like the 1970s, and since, you know, my uncles, my dad, my cousins, and now I and my sister are both firemen, or firefighters rather. It was just something that we grew up with. I grew up in a family that was dedicated to service, and it was just made sense to want to help others. So it's about, you know, solving this problem that someone else needs a little bit of help. And so I kind of find that as my duty as an engineer in a way. When I first came into engineering, one of the things that inspired me into it was the firefighting. There's a lot of different tools and mechanisms, like the jaws of life, that are like mechanically based. And I thought, oh, like it'd be super cool to like go into that. Lo and behold, it's a much smaller industry than I thought. So I'm not too sure about that anymore, but even still, I plan on going into industry, working probably more in the space and defense programs. And then outside of work, I still do plan on doing things like outreach. Problems are endless in the world. We're never gonna run out of them. But I think simply put, everyone like has their little bit of, I want to change the world. For me, like the humanitarian, the outreach, that's about, I guess, helping like to inspire and enable that spark in somebody. And I think that's really what engineering and really what engineering is all about.
I am Mora Sutherland, and I won the Young Professionals Award. Between freshman and sophomore year, I got to work at SpaceX, which was really cool. I did a fall internship with them. And then in the summer between my junior and senior year, I worked at NASA, and then again between my senior year and my super senior year. It really started with my dad. He has always been like a big science geek and everything. He actually wrote a science fiction book when he was younger. And so when I was little, we would watch all sorts of like cheesy science fiction movies. I really liked the aspects of working with my hands, and I was like, oh, if this is engineering, cool, I'm into it. What I've learned so far from my internships is that I don't like being behind a computer all day, every day. Having to program for 40 hours a week was just not what I wanted to do. So I would really love to find a job that balanced, you know, kind of the computer aspect, whether it's programming or CAD, with hands-on stuff and more like interpersonal stuff, you know, people sort of things. But I would also enjoy doing management, I think. I've had a little bit of management experience with NanoSat Lab, and I enjoyed that. I like this sort of like personal, you know, people aspects of it. And since I've become the president of College Democrats, I've also enjoyed learning more about politics, and I think I would be interested in some sort of a career where I got to help with legislation on like a town or a county level. I like the idea of being able to really like impact an area and create change, tangible change, which I think is best realized at like a county or a local level. In our current day and age, I don't know how well this will age with time, but there's a lot of division in our country. I would just say, you know, like, be open to new ideas and be willing to step outside your comfort zone. It will change your life and the lives of people around you if you consciously try to have an open mind. People coming to the table to solve their problems can only help everybody in this world. So, yeah, be nice to each other.
So my name is Jessica Evans, and I'm the recipient of the Distinguished Leadership Award. I received this award due to my work on campus as a leader, especially with my involvement in AIAA, which is the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics. I started out my sophomore year as just a member of the club and got really interested in the Design Build Fly project team, and kind of transitioned from being a part of that team to pursuing other leadership roles within the club, and eventually that led to me being elected president at the start of my junior year. So I've been a second year president now of the organization. I did not think I would be in this position that I am right now when I came in as a freshman. As a freshman, I was kind of scared, shy, really intimidated to get involved in things. And to be able to lead an organization, talk to individuals from all over the country, talk to large groups of 200, 500,000 people, it has really, I've really grown into this position, and I definitely, as a freshman, would not look and recognize myself at all. I definitely think that UB has helped me with my professionalism, as well as giving me the ability to think professionally and think critically about certain situations. You can kind of have a different mindset going into engineering than when you come out. Engineers definitely have a different thought pattern. So it's really given me that ability to critically think about situations, not just engineering, but in life as well. So outside of school, it really isn't engineering related, but I'm a volunteer at the teacher's desk, which is a not-for-profit in Buffalo. I've been a volunteer there for 4.5 years now, and they give free school supplies to teachers all throughout Western New York. My dad's a teacher, so it hit close to home, and now because I am an engineer, they kind of use that experience that I have to kind of work on logistics or any sort of mechanical issues that they have, any sort of computer issues. So they try to use my qualities that I have as an engineer to help them with their not-for-profit. I just think it's really important for students and individuals to get involved in leadership positions. It might be scary at first. Like I said, I was extremely shy coming in as a freshman, but now I have no qualms about going up and talking to people and striking up conversations. It really has helped me grow as a person, and it's an experience, and as I am right now, would not have happened without pursuing this leadership position that I kind of was unsure of at the time. As a sophomore, you don't think, oh, I'm going to be president and lead this organization and take people to international conferences and competitions and all of that. So it was a little bit scary, but now, looking back, I don't regret any choices that I made in terms of my leadership roles here on campus.
So my name is Ian Desjardins. I'm a junior in aerospace engineering. A lot of the stuff I've done in undergrad, I would throw into a couple of, I guess, different bins. So I've done a lot of research. I currently work in the University of Buffalo Nano Satellite Laboratory. I'm as the chief systems engineer, and I've done that for 2 years now. I've also done an NSF-funded research project at Texas A&M University, where I worked on supercomputing plasma simulations of plasma flow and fault thrusters and instabilities and numerical keying and things like that. And also at UB, I've worked in Dr. Mingyi Zhang's lab on robotics, and largely did a lot of image processing. The underlying theme under all this stuff is that I like space. I like space exploration. That's the type of stuff I want to go work on. You know, real engineering is not like the movies where you're like, I'm going to do it, and then, you know, the music starts playing and you go on the whiteboard and then 2 days later it's made. Even if it's not as cinematic as you think it is, right, it's still real. And it's moments that you realize that what you're doing is real, and there's potentially some consequence there. Those are the really cool moments, so that's why I like it. I've had the chance to talk to a lot of students who've done very well for themselves, and I think a lot of the things I've done to make myself successful I picked up from them. I'm not a very creative person, I'm an engineer. So I just copy from the best. I think it's important to have a lot of hands-on experience because that's how you learn. And it's not hands-on, just hands-on with a machine or hands-on building something. Hands-on can mean hands-on with the equations. It can be hands-on making a program. I do honestly want to work on furthering space exploration. And now is a really exciting time to be alive to work on that. There's the obvious ones. There's SpaceX, you know, with the reusable rockets. There's NASA with all the renewed missions to go to the moon. There's a bunch of startups that, you know, 20 years ago you wouldn't think, oh, there's going to be a space startup that makes money. But now it's like, no, there's actually been very commercially successful space startups that fly fleets of satellites, that build, you know, advanced engine technology. My plan is I'm going to do my best after graduation, go try to get a PhD in something that I think is really interesting, that I think is going to help with that future. Then afterward, I'm going to pick wherever I think I'm going to fit in best to that whole landscape and do what I can, you know, to make men on the moon, men on Mars, men in space stations, people in all these places possible. And so that's how I see the future going for me.